My name is Ashley Brown, a former Division I volleyball player at Washington State University, number 19 to be specific. I, along with many other athletes, dedicated 30 plus hours a week to practice, competition, traveling, studying, weights, film, and class for 3.5 years straight. Although I had a scholarship and was paid a monthly stipend, it was barely enough to live on. NCAA athletes are forbidden to have a job during their season and only allowed to have one during the off-season through the NCAA's consent, and under no circumstances are we allowed to accept any sort of extra benefit from being a student athlete.
So recently, questions have surfaced in the athletic community. Why shouldn't college athletes be able to profit off their name? It's ours after all.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Vandertag, and I played volleyball at WSU. I was a walk-on setter, and being able to profit off of being a Division I athlete would have helped me financially because playing volleyball is a full-time job, and I didn't have the opportunity to get another job, but being able to profit off of volleyball would have helped me with some financial needs that I had.
Social media is a booming industry right now, where athletes with large Instagram followings can post ads on their pages for a profit. Morgan Weaver, former WSU soccer star, can now get sponsors and benefits off of her popularity because she signed professionally with the Portland Thorns. But WSU soccer player Brianna Alger, who has four times as many followers as Morgan, is not allowed to post for a profit on her channel. How is this fair? I made the collegiate national team before my junior season. Professional athletes also playing for their country's team make tons off of sponsors like Adidas, Nike, Under Armour, you name it. Since I was in college, I didn't get the same luxury. It shouldn't be different just for college-level athletes who work just as hard and are arguably just as good.
Hi, I'm Abby Phillips, and I played volleyball for 2 years at Iowa State and for 2 years at Washington State.
Nicholas Strange. I played collegiate baseball at a few different institutions.
I guess personally, I think it's a good thing, especially because like I didn't have scholarship and it was very difficult for me. And I think that there's a lot of players that do walk on and end up like being a really big part of it, and people take advantage of that. And even coaches might unintentionally take advantage of the success of the player, and that player never gets any benefit financially, which can be really hard on a player.
I like the rule because it doesn't guarantee everybody to benefit from it. If they were to institute a rule where all college athletes get paid, then that's a blanket statement and that doesn't really work that well, because I did not make the school money. However, Gardner Minshew made school money, so that man should be paid.
The NCAA voted unanimously to permit students participating in athletics the opportunity to benefit from the use of their name, image, and likeness. The rule is voted on by the state and will begin January 1st, 2023.